What do you think changed its mind, though, from being not on the agenda in February to here are 49 tanks for you now?
I think it's just the importance of what is happening in Ukraine at the moment. Russia's aggression in Ukraine has really undermined global security, and it is the most consequential war in the world at the moment in terms of the scope, magnitude, but it, of course, in terms of the implications and global implications. And it's in the strategic Australian national interest to make sure that we can prevail in this war and Russia cannot get away with what they have done. And of course, our capacity to defend ourselves is reliant on the consistent support from many nations, including Australia, those who believe in democracy, those who believe in the sovereignty of the national borders and the rules-based international order.
Well, you've diplomatically sidestepped the question, so I'll push on with other ones. What difference do you think these tanks will make? For a start, you're going to have to have some sort of reactive armour put on them, won't you? Maybe some jamming equipment, because previous Abrams tanks have been lost to the Russians. But how much difference do you think they'll make once you get that done?
Tanks are an essential part of the land defence, and the land defence at the moment is stretched over 1,000 kilometres long. So the tanks will be deployed with a number of those infantry mechanized troops, brigades, who will be using them. An advantage that we have that we've been using some of similar tanks provided by Americans before, so we already have people trained to do that. And of course, it comes with additional protection, additional electronic warfare equipment, and maybe some additional protection which needs to be applied. But the nature of war, as anything, different equipment is destroyed, different weapons are being made inefficient in the battlefield because there's lots of innovation happening. Nevertheless, the tanks are is a serious contribution to Ukraine's military capabilities.
It's more than 2.5 years since Russia invaded Ukraine, thinking you'd be knocked over in a week. You're still fighting hard. Russia's making a huge push in the east now. It's made some ground, but it's taken huge losses. It's using weapons from Iran, from North Korea, technology from China, and now there are reports of North Korea even sending soldiers. Is that true?
That's also the reports that we are getting, and the Ukrainian president made a statement 2 days ago acknowledging and recognizing the escalation in connection to the deployment of the North Korean troops on the ground. And I think this is what makes Australia's support for Ukraine is even more topical and pertinent, given that Indo-Pacific countries such as North Korea will be encouraged and can be encouraged to destabilize the situation here in the region. We've seen it with missiles and ammunition that they've been providing. Now we're even hearing about the personnel which is being sent there. So it all makes it part now of the Australia's regional security priorities to make sure that Ukraine can prevail in this. But Russia has been forming kind of an alliance with those pariah states, in a way, Iran and North Korea, and we're seeing more of that cooperation. So we're now talking about a global war on liberal democracies.
I'm so glad you made that last point, because I don't think many Australians understand this is part of a new world war. This is the third world war, in my view. You've got Russia, Iran, also sending weapons to Hezbollah and Hamas to fight Israel. That's the second war. Russia backing China's claims over Taiwan. That could be the third battle in this world war. How important in this context, when you've got those four countries, Russia, Iran, China, North Korea, all helping each other in these various wars, how important is Ukraine in this fight against this new fascism?
Oh, it's crucial. It's crucial, and a lot will depend how this war ends. And I think those countries which you mentioned are now just watching to see how that may play out. And therefore, it's so important for the democracies which are supporting us, including Australia, to stay strong and to continue providing that practical assistance for us to be able to withstand it.
Well, you know, you've got the hopes of many Australians going your way. Vasyl Myroshnychenko, thank you so much indeed for your time.
Thanks a lot for having me.